trying to be like the niggas that came before us, you know. Head south. It's the underdog. They don't have a bar. Want the title, but I'm always fighting undercard. It's the underrated.
Yo, all right, right back to you guys. So today what I want to speak on is the pros and cons of playing professional ball in Germany. So first thing I'll review, I'll give you guys a little bit of a rundown on my experience in Germany. I want to give you a rundown on the different leagues they have in Germany on the professional level. And I'm just going to give you guys about 3 to 4 pros and cons of playing professionally in Germany. When I first started off playing pro basketball, I knew nothing at all. I didn't know what leagues were good, what were bad. I didn't know anything about the economy, the culture, and all these things are important, especially when you're looking to play professionally. You got to learn these things. You got to know them. And a lot of people don't have those older guys who are in the basketball world who will play overseas to guide them in this crazy game. And so I want to be that for you if you don't have that person. So first things first, I'll give my background in Germany. So playing in Germany was my first year out. Prior to that, man, I was working at a cleaning company, making shit money, but literally just working out and working part-time and waiting for something to come in, which a lot of you guys are probably doing post-college. Finally got a call in December to play for a team in the regionalliga league in Bayreuth, Germany. I had an agent at the time, and I had two agents. I had an NBA agent because I was trying to go to NBA, and then I had a guy overseas that was just looking out for me because he liked my game a lot. And so the guy overseas is the one who got me the job, and his main reason for me going to this specific league with this team was he thought it was a good starting block for me. He thought that my game would show and I would be able to play very well and, you know, move up from there. And not to mention with this specific team in regionalliga, which is the fourth or third, I believe, division, but anyway, low league. But the thing about it was they were connected to a team in BBL Germany, which is the top league in Germany. He basically said that part of the contract is that I practice with the BBL team every day. I'm able to interact with those guys, play with them every day, learn from them. And, you know, maybe if I'm lucky, I could get a deal to play in BBL Germany. And so I took that opportunity and I went to play in Germany. And went, practiced twice a day, practiced with my team in the lower league. And then I practiced right after with the team in the top league, Germany. A lot of hard days, a lot of long hours spent on the basketball court, a lot of trainings, a lot of sore muscles. But I stuck through it. I did it. The BBL team, which is the top league team, they had a few injuries. Some guys got sent home because of misconduct. And rather than them trying to grab another guy from the U.S., they decided to move me up. And they said they signed me to a 5-game contract at the end of the year. And that's what happened. And, you know, it was a good look to actually get moved up. However, they had some coaching change, so I wasn't able to play on that level. But it was a good sign to know that a team was interested enough to put me on the roster. I'm going to just give you guys a rundown of everything because your situation will probably not be like mine, but it's important you know each league and how it can benefit you. So to begin with, the bottom league in Germany is the regionalliga league. This league, what can I say, man? It's a very low level league. It's like playing reg ball over in the US, in my opinion. The guys playing are, of course, they're working, but a lot of them aren't getting paid to play. A lot of guys are just playing for fun. Typically, there are high level regio teams, which I would suggest doing. If you do go to one, get one that's already established team that's looking to go to the next level, which is Pro B. But the regio teams are they're not great. If you don't have any other offers, nothing's coming through the pipeline, go. At least you played overseas. And I moved away after playing that league. I did get another contract, so I can't say that it wasn't worth anything. But the regio league is the smallest division in Germany. So if you got an agent telling you that this and that, and it's a good league, blah blah blah, it ain't a good league, you're gonna be struggling. You probably gonna be struggling to get 10 people at practice every day, depends on what team you're on. But just very unprofessional, just because there's just not a lot of professionals in that specific league. You got a lot of ex-professionals who may have played back in the day, but you know, really ain't got nothing to show for it. Or you got guys who looking to go professional, or a lot of young guys play there, 17-year-olds who looking to get their numbers. So you might get a nice young player on your team, but overall, man, if you do go in this league, you have to kill. You have to average 20 points a game or over, or you have to win the thing, the whole, you have to win the title. You have to kill that league. Literally, you have to dominate, or there's no purpose of you going there. Because it's not respected. It's on such a low level that if you don't kill, you basically say that you're not a real pro. Next, Pro B. Pro B is a good starter league for guys who are coming out first year, maybe even second year. Regio, Pro B, not high paying leagues as far as money wise, but it's a good stepping stone if you are just looking for somewhere to start your career off. Getting on a Pro B team, you still have to do the same thing as a Regio. You will have to kill, because as far as in the overseas market, it's not highly respected. But if you don't got nothing, it's something. And a lot of the teams are they're somewhat professional from what I hear. I didn't get to play on a Pro B level, but I hear they're somewhat professional. Not to mention, it's a good stepping stone league if you are coming from a underdog background. It's a good stepping stone league. Next is Pro A. Now, Pro A is a really good established league in Germany under the BBL, which is the top league. Very respectable league. If you are able to get in this league, kudos to you. I would accept the offer unless you get see something that's a little bit more money. I don't think they pay as very, very well in Pro A as well. But it is a good league. It's an established league in the European division of basketball. Lastly is BBL, which is the top league in Germany. Now, this league it's a great league, man. I've been blessed to see the bottom and the top. So with the BBL team, I mean, treat it like kings, man. The stadiums are nice. You know, as far as the way they treat you, the apartment. I had an apartment with the other top players in the BBL league. I have my own apartment, 2-bedroom. I'm gonna see if I can find a video for you guys, but I had a 2-bedroom condo, like dope, you know what I mean? Big window, you know, looking over the city. It was pretty dope. They treat you good on that league. A lot of guys get paid good money, really good money. So if one day you're able to reach that, that'll be the, it'd be a great league to get into. Top league Germany, BBL. I'll start off three pros. First pro with playing in Germany is that a big portion of the population are English speaking. In Germany, a lot of the people learn English at a early age in grade school, so they're able to speak it in some form or fashion. Another pro in Germany, I mean, the girls love Americans, man. I say this a lot, but all around the world, man, they love Americans. So if you're single, ready to mingle in Germany, man, you'll find you a nice little European chick that you can hang with, and you know, that's on you. I ain't speaking on nothing else. Third benefit of playing in Germany is that it's a good stepping stone league, guys. There's a lot of reporters in Germany who work for like Eurobasket. I had a few interviews. If you do well in Germany, man, you can make a name for yourself, especially on a respectable level. There's a lot of respect in that country where you can actually, you know, you do well on the level, you'll be able to move up. If you got the good agent, you got a good situation. So, three cons of Germany. For one, it's cold as hell. By the months that we're there, as far as from like September through March, April, May, you'll see a little bit of heat, but March and April, it'll still be cold for the most part. Another con of playing in Germany, if you do play at a lower level, it can mess you up. Like a regio level, you play there and you don't kill for whatever reason, from politics, from the coaches, or you know, you don't know what goes on overseas, but a lot of stuff goes on. You don't do your thing, it could hurt you. I've seen a lot of guys get halted at Germany just because they didn't do what they were supposed to do there. And so what happens is that they aren't able to find another job from there. Third con of Germany is that, I hate to say this about anywhere, but I feel there's a slight racist undertone in Germany. In my opinion, like I said, other players may feel it different, and it's not enough to where I felt like I was uncomfortable about any situation, but there were just situations I got in, I was just like, yo, like, you got to be careful. You know, it ain't America. And you'll see that a little bit everywhere you go overseas, but it ain't America. You know, you got to be careful what you say, what you do, how you moving. Those are probably the only cons I can say, but I love Germany. My personal opinion on it, it's a great country. I love it. I wish I could go back. I had opportunities to go back, had teams looking, and I wasn't against it. I love Germany. I had a great time there. Learned a lot about myself too. That was my first year overseas. So, you know, being away from home that far away, I was comfortable. I began to love the country. I began to love the culture. It was great for me, and so I can't complain about that, but I'll be back, guys, for more intakes on, you know, just different countries I've been through. I won't speak on a country I don't know, so if there is one of my homeboys who play overseas and he wants to kind of speak on one of these countries, then more than definitely I'll get him on the channel so you guys can get his perspective on whatever country he went to. But I'm out. Appreciate you guys tuning in. I see you later. I've been wanting something I can feel. Promise I am never letting up. Money in your palm don't make you real. Foot is on their neck, I got them stuck.